Hello, I'm Simon Whistler. You're watching TopTenzNet, and in the video today, the top 10 things Stephen Hawking taught us about the concept of time travel. The possibility of time travel is often debated and theorized by laymen, but it has also garnered the attention of the titans of physics. Ever since Albert Einstein demonstrated that time dilation is a real thing, speculation has grown about the possibilities of time travel. Einstein's work illustrated that the faster someone travels and the closer they get to the speed of light, the slower time moves for that individual. This is all while time continues to move at the same pace for the people here on Earth. Stephen Hawking, the world-renowned theoretical physicist, did not shy away from the growing speculation about time travel, and in the video today we're looking at some of his ideas. Number 10. Champagne Party. Let's just say that Stephen Hawking was a bit of a skeptic when it comes to traveling back in time. To make his point, he conducted a simple but elegant experiment. He held a party. That's right, in 2009, Hawking decided to host a party with balloons, hors d'oeuvres, and champagne for guests who were willing to travel back in time for the party. Hawking told reporters, "I gave a party for time travelers, but I didn't send out the invitations until after the party. I sat there a long time, but no one came." The Discovery Channel was there to capture the event at the University of Cambridge. In the event that someone happened to arrive, Hawking even made sure to provide precise GPS coordinates, just in case someone became lost through space-time. Number 9. Time machines. Although Hawking was immensely skeptical of the possibility of traveling back in time, he was willing to engage in the notion. According to Hawking, everything, including time itself, has wrinkles and voids in it. These are tiny tunnels in the quantum world that form, disappear, and reappear. However, these wrinkles and voids on the quantum level are far too small for a human to pass through. A time machine that wanted to attempt such a feat would have to capture and enlarge a wormhole enough so that a spaceship could travel through it. If such a device were to be built, Hawking said, one end could be here near Earth and the other far, far away near some distant planet. Number 8. Time travel into the past may be impossible. After his theorizations, Hawking concluded that traveling back in time is probably impossible. He believed that the wormhole would create paradoxes that would prevent it from being created in the first place. An example of such a paradox would be a person traveling back in time and killing themselves before they created the time machine. More importantly, Hawking argued that natural radiation would seep into the wormhole, and the resulting feedback would be so strong that the wormhole, and thus the time machine, would be destroyed. He went even further, suggesting that the creation of such a device may have dire effects. Hawking believed that it may trigger a bolt of radiation that would not only destroy the time-traveling spaceship, but space-time itself. Number 7. Traveling into the future. Although Hawking didn't believe that traveling back in time is possible, he did believe that traveling into the future would be possible. An example he cites is the Earth's mass dragging on time. If the Earth was approaching a black hole, time would slow down for people, and the force of gravity would increase. Naturally, a black hole is a dangerous method, so Hawking proposed the potential of traveling near the speed of light. As one nears the speed of light, Hawking argued, time would slow down in order to protect the speed and also make it physically impossible to ever break it. Therefore, Hawking believed that a human traveling near the speed of light could reach the end of the galaxy within their lifetime. Number 6. The spaceship. The fastest manned spaceship was Apollo 10, and it climbed at a speed of 25,000 miles per hour. In order for time travel to be possible, humans would have to design a spaceship that travels 2,000 times the speed of Apollo 10, which is pretty darn fast. It will also need absurd amounts of fuel to make it through a wormhole while not sacrificing any of its speed. It's unlikely that even Elon Musk is going to be able to do this within the next few years, but someday it's certainly a possibility. Number 5. Paradoxes. Hawking came up with his own paradox named the Mad Scientist Paradox to further describe the unlikely possibility of traveling into the past. He assured us that he didn't like the stereotype that scientists are mad, but in this case, he agrees that the misconception is real. Suppose that this scientist created a device that would allow himself to travel just 1 minute into the past, witnessing his alternate self. What would stop this mad scientist from killing his earlier self? Hawking argued that the mere possibility invalidates the fundamental principle of the universe that cause happens before effects. Hawking said, "I think something will always happen that prevents the paradox. Somehow, there must be a reason why our scientist will never find himself in a situation where he could shoot himself." Number 4. Global positioning system. Unlike many of his colleagues, Hawking firmly believed that time travel into the future is possible. Hawking noted that Albert Einstein was the first to fully grasp the concept of time and prove that there are places where time slows down and others where it speeds up. As a result of Einstein's work, Hawking was convinced that time travel into the future was possible. Hawking suggested that a fuller understanding of global positioning system, GPS, is all the proof that someone needs to conclude that future time travel is possible. A network of satellites orbiting the Earth make satellite navigation possible. They've also revealed that time runs faster in space than here on Earth. The satellites contain very precise clocks, and yet they all gain around a third of a billionth of a second every single day. The system has to correct for the drift, otherwise that tiny difference would upset the whole system, causing every GPS device on Earth to decrease in accuracy by about 6 miles every single day. Now, some might suggest that the problem lies with the clocks, but the truth is that they run fast because time itself runs faster in space than it does on the planet below. The Earth's mass literally drags on time, slowing it down like a stretch in a river. Einstein understood this better than anyone, and Hawking believed that his scientific predecessor proved that time travel into the future is possible. Number 3. Future Travel Transportation System. Hawking not only gave us hope that time travel is possible, he dreamed up a system of traveling into the future. Science fiction writers should probably take note here. Hawking imagined a train track that goes around the Earth. This particular train would need to get as close as possible to the speed of light in order for it to become a time machine. Passengers on this train would essentially have a ticket to the future. The train would accelerate around the Earth again and again, getting faster and faster each time. As the train gets close to the speed of light, time will start flowing slowly on board relative to the rest of the world. Hawking predicted that everything on the train would go in slow motion. If said train left the station on January 1st, 2050 and circled the Earth over and over again for 100 years before coming to a halt on New Year's Day 2150, it would only feel like a week had gone by for the passengers on board. They'd leave the train essentially having traveled 100 years into the future. Number 2. Speed of light. The biggest obstacle in our way of traveling into the future is manufacturing a vehicle that can travel extremely fast. No, we're not talking about Ferrari fast or spaceship fast here. We're talking about close to the speed of light fast. As mentioned earlier, if a spaceship were constructed, it would need to go significantly faster than Apollo 10, the fastest manned ship on record. Hawking supposed that based on the ship's size, it would take a while to reach the speed necessary for time travel. After 1 week, according to Hawking, it would reach the outer planets. Then, after 2 years, it would reach half light speed and it would be outside our solar system. Finally, after 2 years, it would be traveling 90% the speed of light. That would place the passengers 30 trillion miles away from Earth, and the ship would finally begin to travel in time. For every hour of time on the ship, 2 would pass on Earth. Number 1. Stephen Hawking. There are few who did more to make the most obscure and complicated of science accessible for those who wanted to learn more about our universe. Stephen Hawking did it all, writing books and creating television shows that helped educate the masses. One of his greatest contributions to his field comes in his expertise on black holes. Hawking made a theoretical prediction that black holes should emit radiation, which is now known as Hawking radiation. His contributions to singularity also cannot be understated, working on several groundbreaking theorems. Hawking was a titan in his field, and there's been no greater voice in understanding the cosmos and man's place in it. So I really hope you enjoyed that video. If you did, don't forget to subscribe to this channel for brand new videos every day of the week. Also, I've got another channel. It's called Today I Found Out. And on that channel, we have content very much like this, except we dive into one specific subject in real depth. You can check that out through the icon on the screen now. But if you're looking for something else to watch right now, why not check out another TopTenz video or a Today I Found Out video over there on the right. And as always, thank you for watching.